Bucks from MGM Grand in Las Vegas. In addition to all the great matches, they have signed the Disco Inferno against Jacqueline for the television.
But him and DDP talking diamond cutters, and I mean, got to be a winner. Oh, man.
There is.
Do you think Jacqueline can beat him? You looked at me like I was crazy.
No, I think she can beat him. And you know, if that happens,
yeah.
Think about it. Think of the implications if that happens. Now,
I'm going to train you if that happens.
I'm not talking about man versus woman because that's what it is. But if Jacqueline defeats the Disco Inferno at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, a female will hold the world television title for the first time in history. Think about that.
That's a hard pill to swallow for an old man like me.
That's
you know what I mean? I mean, I'm over here talking a good game, but that's a hard pill to swallow.
Same belt that you held at one time.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Absolutely.
Oh, Lord, I wonder, can she take a bionic elbow?
Well, I tell you.
Oh, man. Well, you know, it ain't over yet. We got to get to the pay-per-view.
That's
right. And I guarantee you. But he's got his work cut out right here. When we're talking about a young man that it really knows what it is to train hard and try to get to that pay window. And, you know, for him to beat Disco Inferno, he can't make no mistakes.
That's the way it is when you're
hard buying. Hard body can't make no mistakes.
When you're vying for a major title in World Championship Wrestling. Well, all eyes are on the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas. And ladies and gentlemen, I know you're going to be making that telephone call very soon. Here's a roll-up. One, two. Either your cable company, satellite dish owner, can call Turner Premier, DirecTV with Direct Ticket, or Dish Network, cover one, two. However it is, you can see this event, you'll want to see it because you have in the ring, in the cage, Piper Hogan. Those two names alone.
But they're going to be Pain Blues and Agony Dish down.
That's right. Say it all as far as pro wrestling is concerned. But when you take those names and you put them in a steel cage, the final confrontation, the final battleground, the device, if I can use that term, where wrestlers have used over the years, over the decades, to end feuds.
Settle scores.
They're going to do it coming up at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc in 2 weeks.
Speaking of do it, Disco Inferno now stop the offense of hard body. And you know, Disco really, since he won the title, has got a different outlook on him. Still dances and everything, but once he's in the heat of battle, you need to focus on what in the Disco Inferno, I guess, to him means go ahead doing all that and being able to dance too, you know.
I know what you mean. Head first goes hard body Harrison and the Disco Inferno.
Taking too much time in there. See, you let this guy revive. I'm talking about hard body, get him a win and get to that pay window right here on a major upset. Starting off right here on the Mothership on Saturday night here on TBS.
This is our opening bout, and we have a lot to go. We said earlier, said it this morning on the main event, Bill Goldberg makes his TBS debut later on in this telecast. Plus, we are going to see the return of David Fit Finlay. Remember that man, don't you?
Known also as the
Bruiser, the Belfast Bruiser.
Man,
he'll be here.
If you ain't seen him, fans, you don't want to miss this.
Plus, Lex Luger and Scott Norton go one-on-one in our feature bout later on tonight.
And I'm going to tell you another one, Tony, that's really intriguing to me. You know, Billy Kidman coming off a big win. It's got Willie Waltham coming up later on, and that should be a big night for Billy. You know, once you get a win, you start getting getting up one or two wins and getting that pay window. I'm telling you, I'm looking forward to seeing him tonight.
Billy Kidman had upset on this program last week against Alex Wright. Can he make it two in a row on Saturday night? We will find out. And now,
do you know much about this Willie Waltham?
Nothing about him right now, but we've said that before, and guys have come out of virtually nowhere with big wins. Into the corner, Disco Inferno and hard body Harrison up on the metal turnbuckle. Pounding the side of the head. Harrison has come to fight here, Dream.
Sure he is. Sure he has. I guarantee you.
Sending the Disco Inferno in, the television champion goes down hard.
Get him covered now, hook that leg.
That's what he did, Harrison got a 1-2, but...
I really hate that back cover there. When a guy hooks a leg and turns his back, he really doesn't have all that weight and body down on your chest. And I've always hated that cover. I never would cover a guy like that. I want all my big old body laying on top of him, man. You know, hooking legs and arms and stuff.
And you saw how easily the Disco got out of it. Reverse suplex.
Hosted Nitro Uno number 1-0, became number 1-0 without a doubt-o. And let me tell you something, too. The tone has been set for upsets. Fans at home, if you're fans of Buddy Lee Parker, look for something really big to happen right here. Chavo better be on his toes.
Nevertheless, this Monday, we return to the home, the birthplace of Nitro.
Nevertheless what?
As we will be at the Target Center this Monday for WCW.
You don't think Buddy Lee can pull an upset here on this?
I know he can pull an upset.
All right.
I just want to
test. Got him hooked up down an arm bar right there. You're ragging. WCW going all over the country. Nitro coming up live. Expect the unexpected always on the hottest show, period, on television. TNT Monday Nitro Live. Right there. I wonder how Guerrero is doing with his family problem with Eddie. I guarantee it's got to be weighing on his mind right here. That can cost you some time. See how quick and fast he is. Arm whip, missed the drop kick. Buddy Lee very smart right here.
Oh! And now Buddy Lee going to work. By the way, speaking of Eddie, we're going to hear from Eddie Guerrero later on in this program, fans. What would possess Eddie Guerrero to don a mask and try to pull one over on Rey Mysterio Jr., and then he gets beat?
Well, I don't know. A lot
of questions need to be answered about Eddie Guerrero.
Yeah, see, I was going to go ahead and answer that by saying just what you did. I mean, you've got to really look at what I look further back. The mask ain't the important thing to me. It's what happened to this young man. Whoa, got him. There you go. That was so good. Still is good, but attitude-wise, oh, got a nasty look on his face all the time.
Buddy Lee Parker showing his aggressive nature and style. And he has the man where he wants him. This is where Parker would like Chavo to keep him on the mat, drive him home, try to maybe drive a forearm shot in the face or something, keep him off his feet. And Chavo up to the task. Oh, at least he was for a moment, but that knee left in the gut put Chavo Jr. down. And Buddy Lee back to the attack once again here on Saturday night.
Always been a real fine competitor, talking about Buddy Lee Parker. You know, no matter big, small, or whatever, he would get in there and challenge anybody. He understands the importance of getting to the pay window here on Saturday night also. And you're right. By grounding Chavo Guerrero, he makes his chance of winning that much better by keeping him down. Now, speaking of a mean, angry look, you look on Sergeant Buddy Lee's face. Look at him. Oh, man.
You know, what has always made our sport, professional wrestling, the greatest has been the one-on-one competition and the problems that have existed between athletes. You know, you were involved in many of them, but when you look at the lineup we have for Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, Hogan and Piper in a cage, we're going to talk an awful lot about that today, fans. Yeah. That is truly the biggest one-on-one cage match ever.
Ever.
Luger and Scott Hall. Oh, a double axe handle blow with Larry Zbyszko, the special referee. And later, we're going to show the fans the history between Diamond Dallas Page and the Macho Man Randy Savage. Those three matches, three of the biggest matches we've ever had on a pay-per-view event.
Yeah, and when you take a look at that cage match and what it has for us to take a hard, cold look at is Rowdy Roddy Piper not having to prove anything to anybody about his ability. Hollywood Hulk Hogan, he's the man, he's the title holder. But we've seen what damage a cage can do to the Nature Boy Ric Flair.
Yes.
Damage to me through the years. A lot of athletes been damaged in this dangerous confrontation that Piper has set himself upon doing for some reason. Could it be because of the kid? Could it be because of the embarrassment? Oh! Could it be because he wants to drop Hogan on his head just like Chavo did to Buddy Lee Parker?
Only got a two.
Bottom line is it's a dangerous situation to where a man could lose the rest of his career. And I believe Piper knows that. Make no mistake about it, this is not an ordinary cage match with these men in it. This is the event to be bought so far this year.
One, two, three, Rich Suplex.
Your winner, Chavo.
Got it too, right there. You were right on top of it too while I was filibustering. Good matchup.
It really was. Chavo Jr. fights back the attempt of the upset by Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker and gets the win here on WCW Saturday Night. Look at the face. You can tell that there are more problems within the Guerrero family than meets the eye, and there's a lot of problems that meet the eye anyway.
Yeah, there's a lot more problems in the Guerrero family than taking care of Buddy Lee Parker. Buddy Lee Parker had an opportunity to go to the pay window to get a victory, if you will, right here and go ahead and establish himself on Saturday Night. Nice move right there. Chavo Guerrero gets the victory here on Saturday night.
When we come back, a look at Bill Goldberg, plus a look at Halloween Havoc. Future reports will look...
got a look about him that tells me there's something special about this young guy. We're going to find out here, but I guarantee a roadblock on some of his hide right here on Saturday night.
You can look at this physique, and as you see, some Georgia Bulldog fans here, the former Bulldog, all SEC, and a member of the Atlanta Falcons.
But this ain't football. Well, how many times have I heard the legendary Larry Zbyszko say that? But this ain't football. This ain't football. Well, it ain't. It's one-on-one competition between two men with no armor on trying to beat the other, Tony.
You've heard a lot about him. I mean, it'll go down if you go back and look at 1997 when it's all said and done, and they say the appearance of Bill Goldberg will go down as a shocker. He is not as tall as Roadblock, but he apparently fears no man, and Roadblock is doing what you need to do, get the quick start on a guy like Goldberg, and that had no effect. How about that? He said, give it all you got.
You need to be careful when you join at somebody about giving them all you got right there. Guarantee you go behind. Good
maneuver. One.
Yeah.
Only got a one count in.
And see how he got him hooked up, too. You can't get up from that. The big man thought he was going to go ahead and roll up, but right here, Goldberg shows me one thing, that he's got him hooked. Both legs are hooked. And the only thing can happen here is Roadblock to ease himself out. Yeah. That shows me a lot right there. Not only being, hey, this guy's got eyes of steady, but I'm talking about steady in your eyes, meanness in your eyes. Bad intentions, Mr. Goldberg had. Duck under.
Goldberg.
Oh.
Boy, he staggered the big man with a lariat, and how about that?
Drove
gigantic
right into him.
Shoulder
right,
block.
Yeah, he drove right into him right there. You see, great poise, great positioning. Got good wide base about him. That comes from the football.
Sure does. Good point, Dream. But here comes Roadblock, one of the biggest and most talented big men we've seen in a long time, sending Bill Goldberg in hard. He's got the bear hug on.
What a belly to belly.
How about that?
That win streak could be over. Why did he cover him right here?
I have no idea. He wants to make a statement here, I guess. And he may have made a big mistake because Goldberg kicked away.
Tony, he had him
an
opportunity to cash in right there, and he let it go by. But Goldberg is finding what it's all about right now.
Goldberg reeling. Good maneuver. A jumping spin wheel kick that caught the big man and put him down.
Showed us nice wrestling move. Now showed us the Oriental arts. And that was a nice spin wheel kick. And he's showing us meanness now and big elbows and forearms. I'm telling you.
Oh, my goodness.
Talented looking man.
Is he going to suplex this guy?
Well, we'll see what kind of power he's got. Got him up.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, he stood him up, Tony.
Help. One, two, three.
Wow.
An incredible display of power.
That's big time sports right there. I guarantee you. That's big time.
In a span of 3 weeks, Bill Goldberg has solidified himself as a player in professional wrestling. And if there was any evidence, it was right there. As we're going to take a look at our Castrol torture test of the week, Gendry.
I tell you what, Goldberg showed a lot of things, including some martial arts moves. He showed good wrestling moves, but extreme power in a man with bad intentions in his eyes shocks WCW for the third week in a row here on Saturday night.
Castrol GTX motor oil that stands up to the most torturous conditions. Do not forget the name, Bill Goldberg. We'll be back.
Kevin Sullivan obviously does not like Hulk Hogan. Well, shouldn't his brother realize, don't make your older brother upset, don't make him mad? He should come out with a Sullivan t-shirt, a Sullivan hat. No, he's wearing Hulk Hogan clothes. I'm telling you, Kevin's gonna slap him around someday till he understands. You gotta make him understand.
Item number one is you don't slap your sibling around.
You're right, you're 100% right. You use a tire iron.
Get the hook for Brain.
You can really part a guy's hair nice with it. On either side.
You're evil. And so is Kevin Sullivan.
Oh, is he ever?
He's calling him a day.
You know, I never liked Kevin Sullivan.
He's looking for his brother who went down the chute.
I never liked him because of his attitude. But the way he is now, he's a Kevin Sullivan from the past. He's a Kevin Sullivan that takes charge. He's the kind of a guy I like. I want to have on my side.
Well, you're right. He's one of the toughest in our sport. Won the Loser Leaves WCW match going away.
Beat Cactus Jack.
That's right.
No one thought he could do it. Polished him off very, very easy.
What a pay-per-view that was, and what a pay-per-view Halloween Havoc will be. And now in the midst of bad blood with Hogan, the Sullivan family looks to survive.
Oh!
Kevin's way, that is. There's a knee to the gut. Kenny Kendall. Uh-oh. Here's the coup de grace.
That'll bring up your turkey dinner. From 1957, Thanksgiving. Extra cranberry sauce.
Let's look, Tana Hogan! And Kevin's irate.
Good human eyes. Chant all you want for Hogan.
I guess we're going to try to find Dave for this interview with Mean Gene.
Who knows where that imbecile went?
Dave! Eat
it! The country's premier coverage of NPC sanctioned bodybuilding events featuring in-depth.
With the starring Lancaster. Set to go in this tag team matchup. The Fantastics are back, and here's a team that's had a lot of success right here on TBS and a lot of success worldwide. There's Tommy Rogers, Bobby Fulton on your right. They're back again, and they are dynamite, Bree.
No, they've held a lot of titles. They've been up and down the roads in this sport, and they just know what to do. And can beel himself. They're quick and they're fast, and like I said, they've held a lot of titles. The tag team competition here is like I've never seen it before.
Well, there is certain bad blood between the Nasty Boys and Harlem Heat. Now, that match has not been announced as of yet for Starrcade, but we're going to be hearing from Harlem Heat a little bit later on. And I believe we're very close to signing Harlem Heat and Nasty Boys for a big return match for Starrcade from what happened at the Clash of the Champions just a couple of days ago. By the way, the Clash of the Champions replay is tonight at 10:05 right here on TBS. So make sure you join us. Cross body block. If you miss it, of course, maybe you live out on the West Coast and it was a little bit too early for you, you can see it tonight, 10:05 Eastern time. And of course, that's 7:05 out on the West Coast.
I believe he did pull the hair.
I believe you're wrong.
Me?
Yeah. Well, you have been wrong once in a while.
1972. Okay. Big deal. One time.
Mark Starr will come in. Starr's a fine athlete out of Dallas, Texas. And here comes Tommy Rogers.
Look at this.
Double team. And teamwork is what they're known for. Just like the World Tag Team Champions, the new one, Stars and Stripes.
I didn't think they'd upset Pretty Wonderful. I did not believe that would happen.
I really think Bagwell and the Patriot had one of their better matches ever.
Well, they didn't really pin home, though. He pinned himself. He was waiting for Roman to come with the finishing maneuver. He just held the man there.
Well, too bad. I mean, those things happen in this sport.
I know. It's no skin off my ears, but I mean, I'm just saying. Shouldn't happen.
Starr's got Rogers caught in the corner. Here's a series of knees now into the midsection. Rogers held on nicely. Look at the quickness of Tommy Rogers. And on the outside goes Mark Starr.
Where's he going?
He's going up top and then down. Rogers rolls him back in, and here's Bobby Fulton waiting for him. Rogers is a legal man, though. Here's the tag, and here comes the teamwork. The trademark, one of them, of the Fantastics. They're looking great here, Brain.
Well, they do it quick, and they do it in shape, and I guess they are dominating this match. And if you say they look good, well, then I'd have to disagree with you, because I've noticed a couple of flaws, but it's not up to me to say.
Of course, since the fans like them and the girls cheer for them and they're fan favorites, you don't like them.
It's not that. What's going to happen with the fans?
Well, look at this. Head scissors by Bobby Fulton. Take down a Mark Starr. Tomorrow night, live, fans are going to be jammed here in the arena in Atlanta. We're going to bring you the main event live. But you fans who are watching on TV tomorrow night can call our special hotline number and determine by your vote who should be in the main event.
It's that can
interactive,
be dangerous.
It's interactive TV. It's brought to you only by WCW on the cutting edge of wrestling. Tag is made. And a short arm scissors applied there by Bobby Fulton. I'll make it Tommy Rogers. Good look at Tommy.
Does he have a chicken franchise?
No.
That's
Kenny Rogers.
Just ask. I want to see if you knew. See, I knew he didn't.
Oh, you knew that, huh?
Oh, I knew that. But I didn't know if you knew that.
What's the weight limit for the Cruiserweight title?
Never mind. I'm telling you.
You don't know.
I do know.
A pickup over the top. Rogers! Rogers! Nice maneuver.
And I believe there may be a surprise tomorrow night in one of the dressing rooms.
Okay, what is it then?
Oh, I'm not telling you. Then you'd know.
Knee left. Look at this teamwork for the Fantastics.
This way I know and you don't know.
Snapmare takeover. On to Frankie Lancaster now. Spinning toehold here. Look at this. Out of the Funk Family book. Uh-oh, he's pushed right into Mark Starr. Great maneuver by Lancaster.
Don't let him lay there, Frankie. Put the boots to him. There you go. Get him back to your corner. You don't get paid by the hour. You're paid if you win the match. Get it over with.
Starr back up on the apron now, and you see Bobby Fulton trying to get into Tommy Rogers here.
Hurry up and finish him off. I got things to do.
Oh, yeah?
I got to cut all the phone lines here in Atlanta.
Well, you really are against the fans having their way.
I don't like them to have any power. I'm sorry about that.
Oh, the top and that time! Bobby Fulton hit hard. Should have been a disqualification, but no, the match. Well, close line.
I'd like to say something about Mr. T also.
And he didn't have that much experience refereeing, but he tried to take command. There's not much you can do when someone nails you with a
megaphone.
With a megaphone.
But T shouldn't have been in there in the first place. I don't believe he was a qualified official.
Stomping on the chest.
Should be back in Chicago bouncing people out of those restaurants and places he works or hangs out. I don't know what he does. Doorman or valet parking. I'm not sure what he does.
The exchange in Mark Starr.
There's no doubt about it that T's a tough guy. No doubt about it at all.
All right. Rogers needs his partner and a longtime partner, Bobby Fulton, to get back into it. Mark Starr, though, looking very confident here with a reverse chin lock. And the fans...
But all you've got to remember is seven numbers. Think of that. And put them together.
Maybe one day we'll give them the old write-in votes. Where we'll maybe go a couple of weeks out. And maybe they'll write in the name of Heenan.
I don't participate in the ring anymore.
Oh, okay.
I have a bad neck, as you know.
I know. One, two, and there you see Fulton getting out of that two count. Mark Starr putting a hurting on Bobby Fulton here, Bray.
Well, they could upset the Fantastics.
Head scissors applied. Frankie Lancaster, a little added leverage here. Starr and Lancaster have been quite a team over the past couple of months of World Championship Wrestling.
What's Patrick doing? Nick Patrick trying to change the flat?
And may not be surprised to see Lancaster's name, Starr's name, in the brackets for the Cruiserweight Tournament. We do understand it's going to be 16 men in the tournament. Should see a lot of action. Pick up and a side suplex that time for Mark Starr.
I hear from all sports, right?
All over the country.
All over the world. I mean, a hockey player could apply, right? A boxer. I mean, anybody could get into this tournament.
I don't think they're going to go that far.
Well, I
know a lot of hockey players need a job right now, but I don't think they'll be wrestling. On the chest. And Bobby Fulton
genitalia.
Oh! Wow, and a DDT on Mark Starr. Frankie Lancaster's in, and we've got all four going at it. The double coconuts. And they're paired off in opposite corners.
Like the beginning of the end for Lancaster and Starr.
We'll see. Crossbody block. Oh, saved that time by Lancaster. Starr being the legal man here. Up top, the Fantastics go. Starr cannot get up. And a Fantastic goal, team elevation. 2-3, they win.
That's impressive.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, Tommy Rogers, Bobby Fulton, the Fantastics.
The Fantastics secure.
Fantastics knew they were running out of time, so they just turned up the heat a little bit. Look at that drop kick right to the side of the face. They knew they had to get some teamwork. They had to get something going here, and they did. And look at this move. Very impressive. The Fantastics. One, a two, and a three. It's getting tougher here.
You're not kidding. They move into the tag team scene, and like you said, it's getting tougher. And when we come back, the Honky Tonk Man.
Otani over in Japan, Chris Benoit, Eddie Guerrero, JL, Malenko. You have to say, though, Brad Armstrong has to be one of the favorites because he's a former champion. He knows what it's like to help with
the title. You know, Rey Mysterio and Zach Colton and all them guys that you had mentioned, plus many more. And let me tell you something. It would be hard-pressed for me to say I got to beat Brad Armstrong two times, much less have to beat Dean Malenko two times to get him out of the tournament.
Right.
Because Brad Armstrong is always on the verge. I don't care if it's with the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, or whoever, are beating somebody. He has that kind of tool and that kind of ability. And he's so quick. So quick. And the bad thing about Dean Malenko, if there is a bad side, is the Iceman never shows his emotion, and sometimes that throws your whole game plan off.
I want to remind the fans, we have some great wrestling action coming your way on the 20th of April, Little Rock at Barton Coliseum. It's all coming your way. The Superstars of World Championship Wrestling will be in Jackson, Tennessee on April 21st with a big event there at the Oman Arena. And our fans down in Lakeland, Florida, as Brad Armstrong sends him down, but a great head scissor maneuver by Dean Malenko to get out of that. World Championship Wrestling is coming to Lakeland, Florida on Sunday, April 28th, 7:30, the Lakeland Civic Center. Tickets there at the box office and all Ticketmaster outlets. The day before, though, Jacksonville, the Coliseum on Saturday, April 27th. World Championship Wrestling returning to the Sunshine State. And, of course, returning to a city near you very soon.
Right here, we've seen a little give and take right off the bat. Maybe a little filling out process on both guys right here. A lot of respect from both guys, but that's the right thing to do. Whoa, what a nip up. You do a hip toss, hugs, hung onto that arm. There you go, taking a page out of the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Taking a page where you go out, regroup, get yourself back together. There's no reason now for Brad Armstrong to go out there after him and fall into that pit or that game plan that Dean Malenko had, because he just threw him off just a little bit. Yes, going into Florida, Lakeland Civic Center, Jacksonville, most stomping ground. I guarantee the wrestling fans to be ready to see the big boys when they come to town, because the big boys play at WCW.
Now, WCW has been red hot, and that's because the intensity of our athletes and of the matchups and the bitter rivalries we've had. I mean, if you take a look at what had to happen tonight, that security has had to really guard and keep restrained the Macho Man Randy Savage from coming out here once again, as he had over the last couple of weeks, attacking Ric Flair. That situation there. Hulk Hogan had to take on two men this coming Monday at Nitro. An eight-man tag still to come. The tournament going on. Return matches like the Belfast Bruiser, the woman against man match. I mean, it's all here on Saturday night.
Well, you take a list of the lineup right here of the athletes we have at WCW. When you go along, you compare them to great, great athletes around the world. When you talk about the Cowboys and the 49ers, you take a hard look at the great Yankee teams and the great Celtics teams. There is not anybody anywhere but WCW has the greatest athletes in the world. You've seen a great exchange right here, float over right back into the arm right here. Nobody's been able to really take an upper hand in this cruiserweight tournament match right here. And De Malenko knows if he loses this one, it's Heidi Oates. You know what I mean? Heidi Oates, Heidi Oates, I'm gone. I'm out of here.
Here's a whip to the left side. Malenko with a high knee and a good one at that. Malenko with a lateral press on that one, and Brad kicked out with authority that time.
Did you say high knee or high knee?
High hyphen knee with a K.
High knee.
Yes.
High knee.
We got to spell things for the Dream now.
It could have been either way. It was so close.
Yeah, I know. It was up around that area, wasn't it?
Yeah, in the best period.
Driving the knee down to the forehead. So many ways that Malenko can beat you, but I think Brent Armstrong is well prepared in this match. Hooks both arms behind him. And look at Brad bridging out, preventing the shoulders from going to the mat. Malenko now just moves the body forward, but still, Brad, bridging. Look at that.
Yeah, you know, a lot of people at home, too, they say, well, that guy with the shoulders wasn't down. Have you ever seen an amateur wrestling match when you go in there from the time you're a child and you're going up here to where the big boys play? Them shoulder blades is what are counted down.
That's right.
When them are down, now that arm might be sticking up. I know that's right because I'm analyzing it and I'm saying it. That's why it's right. I'm doing some analyzation and you're gawking. The ring girl walked by and you're gawking.
And now
if the Olympics had gawking, I'm going to enter you as an Olympic gawker. Gawking.
Hey, reach through and an abdominal stretch.
A little help here, too, looks like.
How about that? Pulling down the middle rope, and why would one would ask, would a guy like Malenko need this rope?
Well, I think he got a little devious heart, you know what I mean, inside of him, too.
I think so, too, and yeah. I think also his back is up against the wall. He used every measure he could get here.
There you go. That's the call.
He tried to hook him again, and he dumps him on the outside. Uh-oh. And then Brad took a nasty spill that time, hit his head, as you can see. Malenko, as Nick Patrick's done a heck of a job in this match. You saw moments ago making sure the shoulders were down or weren't down, actually. And in a reversal, Malenko hit top. Good move by Dean Malenko.
Yeah, it was. Now he's going up to top. Brad needs to turn around right here.
Cross body. Brody Muller. 1, 2.
Oh, he almost eliminated Dean Malenko.
And he got out of it in a two count. Malenko scoots underneath. What quickness. Both men exhibiting. What a weight class.
Whoa, he got it.
Russian leg sweep. This could be it. 1, 2. No, whoa. He got out of it.
I cannot believe he kicked out of that, Tony.
Out of his patented Russian leg sweep. He got out. Back body drop. Brad Armstrong looking good here.
Yeah, looking good.
He may be a little frustrated now that he got out of the Russian leg sweep. He held the ropes. Throws him up. 1, 2, Brad got out of the two count.
Well, I tell you what, hard fought. Lot at stake on Saturday night.
Whoa, picked him up. Look at this, vertical suplex. Brad standing switch, pushing him into the ropes, rolls him up. 1, 2, 3.
Hey, I'm gonna tell you what.
We need to send this one out. Brad, I'm tough.
Brother. You know what came to play? The analysis just came to play that I talked about, the shoulder blades a while ago. They just come into play.
The shoulder was up. You saw Nick Patrick say it. The shoulder blade was up. Both men had their shoulders down. Brad got the shoulder up at the three count. Dean Malenko has been eliminated, and that was a wild one and a great one here on Saturday night.
That was a huge victory for Brad Armstrong. Dean Malenko is out of the tournament. You see right here, now Brad Armstrong got him up just a little bit. Now look at this thing. See his arms resting. You see his shoulder blades up right there. I'm talking about Brad Armstrong. Good call by the referee. Going to take another look at it right here. Shoulder blades up. Good call by the referee. Brad Armstrong advances on Saturday night, and this was a major win for Brad Armstrong.
You're right. The arms across the arms of Malenko, shielding the three count. Your winner, Brad Armstrong. Malenko is out of the...
Right now, Alex Wright, young fellows, amateur champion in Bavaria and in Germany. In his academic career, his amateur sports, weightlifting and wrestling.
Weightlifting?
Oh, yeah. He developed, however, into the long, ropey muscles as opposed to the short, tight muscles.
I was going to say, if he's lifting weights,
take those big round things and put them at the end of the bar.
Oh. Yeah, maybe he just used it in the bar.
Bar.
Well, whatever it was, he is a sensational young athlete, good-looking kid, and obviously extremely popular. He's only 18 years old.
Well, God, he does have that youth and that speed and that drive to be tremendous. But when you get in there with men's like we talked about with Vader, and we get in there with men like Larry Zbyszko or Dustin Rhodes or the great athletes of the world's heavyweight champion Hulk Hogan, you've got to understand some people come to different places and points in time to put seriously body hurt on somebody. Stinger had felt the wrath of this new man, this 400-pound giant they call the Avalanche, brother. And these types of situations happen, and these types of situations are going to continue to happen.
All right. Let's just take a look right here.
Let's take a look at it. You have to stay on top of your game. Right here, you see, my psychedelic producer, I can barely see this screen. Could you make that bigger, please? Bring that up. So, yeah, rewind that. I love that. It's like my little controller.
Excuse me. What time are you walking across the lake?
Well, we're going to sell tickets at 11. Anyway, you see Avalanche, who came in here, jump Sting. This is just recently. Kevin Sullivan is there. Right here, the Avalanche possesses the power of just what his name says. Avalanche, watch this shot here on Sting's chest. Drives it down into him, brother. One thing is perfectly clear here. Hulkamania running wild around this country. Friends are far and few between, and he faces a big foe in the Three Faces of Fear.
Yeah, Three Faces of Fear upcoming during the Clash of Champions. Avalanche, the Traitor, and Kevin Sullivan. Well, I'll tell you, the Traitor is something that just amazes me, that he could turn his back on Hulk Hogan after all of the things that Hulk Hogan has done for him.
Oh!
Almost had the pinfall that time.
Almost. I saw some teeth fly. He got nailed.
Well, that's one of the things that... There's a tremendous move by Alex Wright. Flying cross body block. Comes back with a lateral press, hooks the far leg, gets the pinfall. Yeah, he's nursing a couple of loose teeth, that's for sure. But he emerges victorious, and that's the important thing. Alex Wright, young German champion.
But you know, God, Alex Wright possesses what we talked about earlier. He's got that new... got that basic skill. I think he needs to put a little more weight on his body, but right here makes some great moves. Got to understand one thing, Alex Wright, getting ready for big time competition. Got to step it up a notch, brother, because we're in the heat of the battle, clashing champions.
It's upcoming. Talking about that, let's go now to a WCW control center. Seeing Craig Pittman going up against Ken Kendall. Don't forget, of course, tomorrow night, exclusively on pay-per-view, it will be Lucha Libre. And it's going to be a fantastic series of matches exclusively on pay-per-view. International in its proportion, with some of the great Mexican stars of all time. And, of course, they're known as high flyers.
I tell you, one guy... looks like a low flyer and very stout here is Craig Pittman. You know, this guy wrestled 15 years for the Marines, tough individual, one of them survivalists. I mean, dresses like shrubs, lives off of bugs, and look at the way he can zip on for that leg.
Beautiful single leg pickup. Kendall tried to upend him, but Pittman, nice move by Kendall. Kendall's been around the horn. Look at here, trapping the leg very nicely. Beautiful counter by Craig Pittman. Look at the legs on Pittman. He is a solidly built individual.
Well, you can tell by the way he moves, the way he keeps his neck up and his center of gravity right there. This guy can wrestle.
Well, the opportunity at WCW Pro, we talk about it every week. People from Europe, Mexico, great athletes are coming to this country. We get them first right here Saturday morning at WCW Pro. An opportunity to take a look at him. Pittman falls in that category.
He does indeed. You're going to be seeing a lot more of this young man. Nice single leg pickup once again by Pittman on Kendall. And of course, immediately following this match, we're going to go back to 1992 and
What is so funny here? What are you laughing at?
No, we just you know, it's just like present when you know somebody else, don't you get,
and you
get kind of chuckled about it? No, no.
I'll give you a chance. At least I could grow a mustache.
But, are you talking about my growth or my...
Oh, is that a mustache?
Yes, that's a mustache.
It's looking good. Kendall trying to get a move on his man here. Pittman tying him up. Pittman, Raiders catch can, also Greco-Roman. Once again, that single leg takedown by Kendall. Kendall relying on the basics here now. Pittman. Ooh, what?
There's a basic.
Man.
Looks like there's not a very long fuse on Mr. Pittman.
Hell no, he's...
You know, Gunn, I want to say real quick, you know, say hello to two of our big fans out there in Dallas. Big Nate Newton, God for the Dallas Cowboys, Barry Switzer. Every Saturday morning, WCW Pro, they are on the air out there Central Time looking at us, brother. Two great. I get a letter through them, maybe two a week.
Well, very good. Glad to hear that. And I'll tell you what, like I said, we're going back to 1992 right after this match is over. We're going to be taking it our WCW flashback, and it does concern what's going to come up at the Clash of Champions. We're going to take a look at a great young athlete. Right now, let's go to our flashback.
Of the champions next Wednesday.
Well, this is more than a wrestling match, Shivani. This is serious now. You know, Butcher has been pushed around all his life. He's been used. He's been mistreated by Hulk Hogan, whether you believe it or not.
I don't.
He came between the family, Hulk Hogan did, and the Sullivans. Look what he did there. This has been made personal now. Very, very personal. They've got this big avalanche now, who I tell you is going to stop Hulkamania. Look what he's done to Sting. Look what he's done to the idiot, David Sullivan. I'm telling you. It's dangerous. It's really dangerous.
No question, the Avalanche is the type of guy who can end Hulkamania, because it wasn't that long ago our fans were cross body block. One, two. That this man Avalanche, a mortal enemy of Hulk Hogan, trying to put him in a hospital. One, two. Look at Brad Armstrong go after the World Tag Team Champions here, Brain.
Yeah, but look at Orndorff. He was smart enough to go down on his back, get to the ropes. Take it easy. Regroup. Couple good old Georgia boys. Where are they from? Mayberry?
No, they are from Marietta.
Marietta.
Side headlock. It's one of the greatest places to live in the world. And that's all I'm saying about that. Yankee down on the arm now.
It's my second favorite place to visit. Everything else is tied for first. The Armstrong family's amazing. Look at Brad, and there he's kind of has a 1990s hairdo. And if you look at his brother Whoopi, he's kind of got shag carpeting on.
Crucifix, Brad Armstrong rolls up. Romo!
Yo!
Whoa! That was so close. The arm was coming down with a three.
That was real close.
Do something about that.
Don't forget, the Armstrongs have been together longer than Pretty Wonderful. They've been together all their lives.
It's going to be a big event next week on Worldwide. Paula and Paula.
That woman sitting next to him was bigger than Aunt B.
Tag. The double axe handle, and this is great teamwork from the Armstrong brothers.
Roma's been in there a long time. He's got to make a tag.
You're right about that. Meanwhile, the Armstrongs doing exactly what you told Roma to do, and that's make the tag. Get things moving back and forth quickly.
Well, you got to understand something, too. Being World Tag Team Champions, it takes a lot out of you. Because in the nights when you do defend a title, you're defending it against the best. And people just don't want to beat you. They want to beat you because there's more involved in beating anybody else. So their bodies take a tremendous amount of punishment. Their travel schedule, they got to get to a gym and work out. I mean, it's not easy being champion of anything.
Here's the double axe handle. Actually, it was a forearm shot to the back of the head. You think it was unusual that he needed a tag but didn't make it?
he went up in his corner and tried a high-risk maneuver? Such confidence, such arrogance from Roma.
You would ask me about something being unusual. Why don't you ask Brian Armstrong about unusual things that are on his head?
Big elbow drop from Roma, and he covers him, and this may be over. One, two. No, it's not, and boy, it shocked Orndorff because he had turned his back.
He thought he had it.
That's right, and Orndorff finds himself quickly in, and a hair takedown. The face, the side, the jaw of Brad Armstrong. Now Brad needs the tag to Brian, and he's not too far away. And he gets cut off by Roma. Almost made the tag, but didn't. Ooh. But meanwhile, Brian's in, and that enables Orndorff. Was he a punter in college?
Oh, I think he was a fullback. He could have punted and could have field goal. He could have been the quarterback. He could have done it all. Tremendous athlete.
Well, he was from right outside of Tampa, Brandon, right?
They call him the Brandon Bull.
The backslide. The bull may be down.
Did he get it?
He counted three. Did he?
No, he's letting the match go on. I thought he counted three, too.
I thought so, too. Wow, that was close. Brad Armstrong repeatedly has had Pretty Wonderful on the ropes here. Now remember, Pretty Wonderful, the World Tag Team Champions. A win here in this non-title match certainly would propel the Armstrongs right up near the top.
Oh, of course. Well, look at the shape Orndorff's in. You know, that man's never had a large sandwich.
Who has?
Okerlund.
Okerlund has had a large sandwich?
To go. A whole week, though.
Oh, there you go. Gotta watch that cholesterol. Forearm shot. Brad Armstrong. What athletic ability, but a tag has been made and Armstrong's caught.
He's trapped.
Yeah, that means the same thing, kind of.
Now, caught is when Gene gets in at 4 a.m. with his shoes tucked under his arm. Trapped is what happened to that guy. The wrong house.
Oh my. Brad is fighting.
But no, the knee. Well, it's time for a fresh Armstrong. Look at the agility.
Shut up, you kid. You just keep your mouth shut.
Can Brad Armstrong make the tag?
Yes.
Well,
yes. Pretty Wonderful made the tag.
And notice how Orndorff quickly cut off any potential tag from Brad Armstrong. He needs Brian, and he holds his position. He's got a sleeper up.
They don't have it locked good.
It's a desperation move, and he's going back toward the wrong corner here.
He's trying to regroup himself.
Look at this. Double team, Pretty Wonderful. Brian Armstrong saw it coming, but in his attempt, he actually hurt his brother even more. Tag! Brian Armstrong.
Come on.
We might get a disqualification here if Brad's not careful. A pickup. Belly to back. A cover. And Brad Armstrong had seen enough.
He reached him.
Yeah, there was no tag. Orndorff just rolls over and covers Brian Armstrong, and this one's over. Incredible.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the World Tag Team Champions, Pretty Wonderful.
Fans still are coming to telecast. Hulk Hogan.
Well, Wrestling fans, I'm joined now by newcomer to the NWA Southwest, Crazy Luke Graham. And Luke, I have to tell you that some insiders here in the NWA Southwest are a bit concerned about your mental stability.
Hey, baby, I'm sane. I'm sane.
Well, let me ask you about this Friday night.
Ask me anything you want to ask me. Go ahead. I love you. You know I love you.
This Friday night, you'll take on Ponytail. Jared Steele.
Jared Steele? Who's that? Tell me who Jared Steele is. Is he somebody I should know? Have I ever wrestled him anywhere else? Have I ever seen him anywhere else? Or is he some young, green, young individual that just can't get off the pot? I've seen. I'm going to tell you what I do. I introduce him. I got 4 ring posts out here, okay? You be a ring post for me, okay? Now, Jared Steele, we're going to take you from right over here. We're going to put Jared Steele right there on your head. You got it? And then I'm going to kiss you. Oh. Just like that. Because it's hardcore, baby. I'm telling you why the Grahams are... Okay, it's hardcore. That's why the Grahams are coming to town. It's crazy, Luke Graham. It's the way that I'm going to introduce him. You're a ring post, right? Be a ring post. Be a ring post for me. Okay, now, come be a ring post right over here. Okay, now, from this ring post, we're going to come ring post him just again, just like that. Okay, then I'll give him a big shot. All right, and that looks like this. You ever seen one like that? Huh? That's good looking at it. Jared Steele, I've never met you, brother, but you ain't the man to beat Crazy Luke Graham. You don't even know who you are. Your mama won't know who you are, because I ain't seen nobody that looks as good as I do in a pair of red trunks. Matter of fact, what's your name?
Richard Hunter.
You ain't Jared Steele, are you?
No.
You're not trying to fool me, are you?
No. Jared Steele looks nothing like me. It's this Friday night. Crazy Luke Graham taking on Jared Steele.